Maila Maila, the Inkates. You see, in Siv Vav, the Rebbe starts speaking a little about Tetz and Tach. I mean, when he's explaining these two phrases, you can see from there, like, why this is Tetz and why this is Tachlis. Ho'ili v'shleimus. One is to bring to be Mam Shechayis and world, in Asiya Guf in the lowest level, Shein Tach and Lamata Memeno. In other words, in lowliness. On the other hand, in Eilam Esol Yenim, Lamaila, then Tetz is Be'ein Arecho Kelei Choshif. Seems like it's more spiritual level, the union of Tetz. But Lamazen, I'm just thinking if there is a psa'uisfir dom with them. Bemis, there's two maimorim, Kinzir, Zain, and Tzuitin. I don't see anything over here. Faces. This is actually the Rebbe's original maimor, because the union of Eir and Sof is used in many different maimorim from the Rabbeim. They're used Bechlal. The Rebbe's, this concept of infinite revelation in all directions, higher and lower, is the Rebbe Rashab uses it in a Vayigash Maimer. The Mittal Rebbe uses it in Teres Chaim in Bishalach, Tzitkas Pirzeine, that's the Avtera Parsha Bishalach, the Shira, the Song of Dvera. The Friedrich, the Rebbe Rashab also uses it in Tofresh Pei, Boy, Vahi Be'etzem Ayem Azeh Yotze Kol Tzivis Hashem, which actually, Yotze Kol Tzivis Hashem Eretz Mitzrayim, Tzivis is the union of Milchama, and that is what the Basi Ligani is based on, 1950. So it's all, everyone is on the different Pasik. The Rebbe connects it with a Pasik Naftera from Pesach. This is a big Gilui, this. Even amongst the unique Maimorim, they were called the Maimorim in the early 50s, all of them were like, everyone was a Maimor in its own right, with its unique qualities. This is like, stands out, because it's like a Hemshech of two Maimorim, in the middle of the year, Pesach, relatively, not Tishrei, and the Rebbe connects it with a Pasik, it's like a whole thing, this is basically the union of what Drush means. So, B'meila, see weiter, this is another paragraph from Schopstam. Obiyar ha'inyan, to understand, she'asa sviris da'atzilis nekroim gufe, obiyalavushim, to understand that the 10 spheres are referred to as bodies. And biyah are considered garments. Way mekiyaser and deeper on a deeper level. Yuvan behag them dachilik shabein levush hamiyuchad levush hanifradu. The difference between a levush, a garment which is connected with the person, the levush like the body to the soul, the levush hanifrad something that separates. So the Rebbe says the difference is not only uleirakim efshel lepeishtei elav, not only if you can take it off or not. Elaviiker sheim chalukim binyana. That they basically represent, express two different concepts. The pirush levush hamiyuchadu she'ini inyan latzmi. Levush hamiyuchad means when a garment is completely connected with something else. For example, the body with the soul. So he is not an entity for itself. Dikashe yesh le inyan latzmi. That when he is an inyan for itself, he's an entity for itself. Although, for reasons, they might not be able to take it off, aber von deswegen, he is still an entity for itself. Which means basically because he has a certain concept, a certain content. Upirush levush hamiyuchad hu shekol inyon hu. What does levush hamiyuchad mean? That his whole inyan is liyis levush v'keili lozeh shemislabesh bei. It is a levush, a garment, and a vessel serving and containing that which is enclosed in it. Is v'zeh uikar achilik. This is also the difference between guf adam la levushim shalei. The difference between the body of the person and his garments. Da levushim emitzias la'atzmo. The levushim, the garments, are an entity for themselves. V'lachene mechasim, not only covering, umalimim, they are concealing. Agufa odom amalubish besechem. They're covering and they're concealing that the gufa odom should not, the body should not be revealed. Mashenkin haguf kolin yonayu liyis levush bekele la nefesh emalubeshes bei. The guf basically is for a garment and a vessel for the nefesh. In order, because the nefesh will be expressing itself through the guf. It does not conceal on the chayis hanefesh because its base, it is designed to be a vessel. It is obvious when a person looks at the body that there is a soul there. And the soul is basically being expressed through the body. So the body is considered a designated the vessel that's part of that's connected very tightly connected with the guf. This is also the reason that the limbs of the body, the organs, listen simultaneously to the will of the nefesh. Person, the rotzen, once there is a will to do something, the person reacts, the body reacts. When there's a will in the soul, there should be some kind of a function, some kind of a deed, activity of the body. The rotzen does not have to order, command the limbs to do it. It comes on its own. It reacts. Because since the whole purpose of the body is to be a vessel for the nefesh, so therefore there is no need to wake up the guf and pressure the guf, nor it's like an electronic message that comes immediately from the nefesh to the guf, from the soul to the body. That the difference between the intellect and emotions, which are part of the soul and tightly connected with the soul, to thought, garment, and speech, and deed, which are compared to garments, alien, not a separate entity, the ikar achilik shebenemu, shemachshava, dibra maise, mitzias la'atzma, thought, speech, and deed are an entity for themselves. Bislapshes ha'seichel v'amidesha behemidov ha'nesev ha'mitziusa. And when seichel directs them, when Seichel goes into them and channels through them, the Seichel Amidas, the intellect and the emotions, are considered something additional to them, because they are actually emetzias for themselves. Therefore, they are concealing because they are an entity for themselves. They're considered a yesh, which is basically a being independently. The intellect and emotions in they are basically vessels designed to contain and express the nefesh and the nefesh inclinations. And it is obvious that the nefesh accomplishes through them. The nefesh thinks through seichel. And it accomplishes chesed, it is generous through the character trait, personal character trait, which is chesed. So it needs basically the keches to express it. That the 10 attributes of atzilus are called gufin, bari, zubiyah, is called levushim, ki biyah gam akelem desa sviris, the biyahim yesh. Because by biyah, even the vessels of the 10 attributes of biyah are considered yesh. They're considered, even the vessels of the attributes, not only the world itself, are considered a yesh, an entity for itself. Mashen kenesses sviras d'atzilus, the 10 attributes of atzilus, gam ha-kelim, heim elikus. Also the vessels are considered elikus.